actually Pepper time.
Welcome to Pepper's Glowworms, a channel dedicated to hot chili peppers and coldly glowing glowworms.
Well, okay then. I have put this off for quite some time now, but my latest chili creation, the Ahi Charipa F1, has some ripe fruits now. And I think I can try them now. They are a cross between the Carolina Reaper chocolate as the father and an Ahi Charapita as the mother. This is part of my quest to breed a small-fruited super hot chili pepper. I started on this journey in 2010, I think, with the at the time Cariolokia, a cross between Butiolokia and Carioca, and in comparison to the F1 generation of that strain back then, it's basically my profile picture of this YouTube channel, by the way. The fruits are comparable in size, but they are on this new Ahi Charipa, they are much more gnarly and irregular, not as smooth as the Cariolokia. And also of note is the color pattern. The Carolina Reaper chocolate is, as the name suggests, somewhat chocolatey in color, brownish, and in the ripe form. And the Ahi Charapita is basically just kind of yellow-orange-ish when it's ripe. So what has happened here is it starts off green, then it turns into a tan by the sun, somewhat purplish, just a hint where the sunlight has hit the fruit. Then it starts to turn orange, somewhat orange in color. Where's another one? And this one, I guess, is still more orange, but the final color is somewhat deep red, which is interesting. Yeah, and now the most important part, of course, is the taste. I dislike the habanero taste. It's somewhat soapy, like peach soap or something to me, not very appealing. But I'm hopeful, because neither of the parents had any hint of this taste, although the Ahi Charapita did smell very much like habanero, weirdly enough, but it had a very distinct and unique taste to my taste buds, at least. And the Carolina Reaper chocolate was basically just incredibly hot, and I could not discern any prominent kind of taste. So without any further ado, let's pick one of those and try it. Well, for the final product, I'm aiming for at least half the size of this fruit. I want to have them nice and small so that they fit nicely into my chili mill and my mouth. Take off the stem. All right. Okay, now let's try it. I'm not gonna take out the seeds of this very first fruit, because there are enough left on the plant to take seeds from, and I want to have the full experience of taking it into the mouth and letting it burst in complete form and not having it cut open in the first place, so that the hot contents are released in a sudden explosion of heat, so to speak. Okay, I'm very excited to taste test this one, but I'm also slightly terrified. Smell is... When I ripped off the stem, the smell was kind of a bit boring. But now that it has breathed a bit, it smells quite nice. Maybe it's like a good wine. It needs to breathe before the full aroma develops. Okay. I have some milk, I have some tea, and some ice cream in the freezer for the emergency. Nice and sweet. I know the heat hurt. The heat hits. There was some juices spraying at the beginning, that's why I coughed a little bit. Nice. Sweet and fruity. And the heat, I guess it's a slow burn, it starts to fire up now. Oh, the taste is excellent. I guess it leans very much in the direction of the ahi chalapita, which I found very delicious. Okay, there is heat. If I remember correctly, the heat of the Carolina Reaper chocolate was comparatively sudden and hard-hitting. I might even imagine a hint of chocolatey taste. Some increased salivation. The spit is collecting. But, I guess the heat is, to be honest, less than half of the heat of the Carolina Reaper chocolate. It might even correspond to the comparatively small fruits, since this means that the total amount of capsaicin and capsaicinoids that are released in my mouth are smaller, the absolute content. But I cannot really speak for the real concentration per weight of the fruit, for example. And now the heat is already starting to subside, I guess. That's even the first super hot chili pepper that I tried this year. So you would assume that I would be exceptionally vulnerable to the heat. Well, it is delicious. There's so much I can say. And well, my tongue feels a bit numb. But right now there's a pleasant afterburn, I guess, in my mouth, and it so far it does not hurt at all in my digestive tract, which I have primed as per usual with a huge amount of oatmeal and milk, so my body was ready, so to speak. My nose is a bit runny now. Well, the heat, you have to improve. Maybe in the next generation or a different fruit that I may try later. They are not all the same necessarily, although this would be ideal and something that I that is my theory, that these chocolate varieties have a more evenly distributed heat among the fruits. They are not is not one is very hot, one is medium hot, one is not very hot at all, which happens in some varieties. And so far what I have seen from measurements of capsaicin and capsaicinoids is that in the chocolate varieties it was more even when you look among the compare between the different fruits. And that was something that was also appealing to me when I decided to cross in a chocolate variety of the Carolina Reaper. I feel good now. No pain in the belly or no tummy hurt. The burn in my mouth has even more subsided now. It's still very noticeable, but not painful. Or just a pleasantly painful, maybe. I'm moderately optimistic about this version of my way to the small-fruited support. If I remember back then, the Caryolochia was also not very hot in the F1 generation. So maybe there's room for improvement. Well, I guess that's it so far. I'm still gonna eat some ice cream now, just to be safe. And, well, I guess that's it so far. In further videos, I will elaborate a bit more on the other specimens of this cross, the F1 generation of the Ahi Charipa, which I cultivated in different conditions, but that's gonna happen in a different video. That's it for now.